All right, so we're on a new turkey property, and we want to show you guys what we do in order to locate turkeys. A lot of times what we'll do is when we find a property, we're going to do a lot of aerial scouting. And what you want to look for is anything with terrain. So we live in a predominantly flat area. So when we do find properties with ridges then and big woods, then there's a high probability that they're going to hold turkeys. So that's one of the first things we look for. In addition, turkeys like to get up on a high spot and fly out over a valley to roost onto trees. So anytime you have a topographical change, that's actually a good spot to focus on for your scouting. In addition, what we do is we get out early. We start 2 weeks before season, and we'll get out about 10 minutes before shooting light. And you have a window from 10 minutes before shooting light to about 10 to 15 minutes before sunrise to get the birds gobbling on the tree. And so what we do is we leverage that window to get into a spot where we can hear as much as we can. And you do that by getting into like open areas, field edges, try to get as high as you can. So if you have the choice, don't be in a valley, get up on a hill. And then we also use our electronic earmuffs in order to amplify the sound around us so that we can hear even further. And then we just get to a spot where we think the birds are going to be. And if they aren't there, if we don't hear gobbling by basically shooting light half an hour before sunrise here, then we're going to start pushing where we think the birds might be. So in this case, this morning, I was sitting right here and I didn't hear anything by 6:30. And I knew that the birds were going to be down on the ground by 6:40 or 6:45. So I just started pushing back through the woods. And when I got about halfway back, I finally heard a bird. And so I started pushing even faster. And I ended up getting a little bit too close. But once I saw the birds, I stopped and was able to get some video of them. Heard some gobbles, saw which direction they flew down. But I think I personally got too close today and I pushed those birds in the direction that they went. So once you locate the birds, then you want to understand what their natural pattern is without any pressure at all. So the next day, what we're going to do is we're going to come out and we're going to figure out how we can get situated around those birds so that we can get in, get set 10 minutes before shooting light while it's still dark enough that they can't see us, and then just watch where they go when they do fly down without any pressure at all. And from there, we make our adjustments and figure out how we want to hunt those birds now that we know what they want to do. So that's pretty much all there is to it. As far as finding birds, you can do it really quickly and cover a ton of properties that way. And really the hardest part is waking up early. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and check out some more of our videos. Thanks for watching.